Hello, hello everyone. This is Brandy and I am back to read the Word of God with you. I am in the book of Matthew, the Gospel according to Matthew. And I'm going to read chapter 6, hallelujah, out of the Amplified Version of the Bible. May God bless you all. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I pray everybody can hear me well, see me well. Hey. Bless the Lord. Well, come on, y'all. In the name of Jesus. So here it is. Verse 1, it says, be very careful, Amplified Bible. Be very careful not to do your good deeds publicly to be seen by men. Otherwise, you will have, hallelujah, you will have no reward prepared and awaiting you with your Father who is in heaven. Be careful. Glory to God. Verse 2, it says, so whenever you give to the poor, whenever you give to those that are in need, whenever you give to the poor and do an act of kindness, do not blow a trumpet before you to advertise it as the hypocrites do, like actors acting out a role in the synagogues and in the streets, so that they may be honored and recognized and praised by men. I assure you, and most solemnly say to you, this is Jesus talking to his disciples, they already have their reward in full. But when you give to the poor, to the needy, when we give to the poor, to the needy, the saints of God, and do acts of kindness, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing. Give in complete secrecy so that your charitable acts will be done in secret, and your Father who sees what is done in secret will reward us. He will reward us openly, guys. Verse 5 of Matthew 6, it says, also when you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, for they love to pray publicly. They love attention, standing in the synagogues and on the corners of streets so that they may be seen by men. I assure you and most solemnly say to you, they already have their reward in full. But when you pray, go into your most private room, go into your secret place, go into the, hallelujah, your prayer closets. Close the door, Father God says, and pray to your Father who is in secret, and your Father who sees what is done in secret, hallelujah, will reward you openly. And when you do pray, in verse 7 of Matthew 6, and when you pray, do not use meaningless repetition as the Gentiles do, for they think they will be heard because of their many words. So do not be like them, praying as they do. For your Father knows what you need before you even ask. God knows exactly what we need before we even ask. Pray then in this way. Our Father who is in heaven, hallowed be thy name, be your name, your kingdom come, Father God. Your will be done, Father God, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day, our God, our daily bread, and forgive us of our trespasses. Forgive us of our debts. Forgive us of our sins as we forgive those who owe us, as we forgive those who've sinned against us, as we forgive those who, hallelujah, have trespassed against us. Letting go of both the wrong and the resentment. Amplified Bible. We let go. When we forgive, we're letting go the wrong and the resentment of a thing. Come on. Verse 13 says, and do not lead us. Father God, in the name of Jesus, do not lead us into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom, yours is the power, and yours is the glory forever. Amen. For if you forgive, he's still talking. For if you forgive others their trespasses, their reckless and willful sin, their reckless and willful sin, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive others, nurturing your hurt and anger with the results that it interferes with your relationship with God. Neutering. Glory to God. But if you do not forgive others, neutering your hurt and anger with the result that it interferes. This unforgiveness, this anger, this hurt that you feel because you won't forgive. Let it go. Let's let it go. Come on. Let's let it go. Me and you, we can let it go. Come on, let it go. Why? Glory to God. Why do we need to let it go? Hallelujah. Excuse me, y'all. Why do we need to let it go? Because it interferes with the relationship with us, with me, and our relationship with God. Then your Father will not forgive your trespasses. If we can't forgive those who've mistreated us, hurt us, made us angry, Father God can't forgive us of our trespasses. Verse 16 of Matthew 6, it says, and whenever you are, glory to God, hallelujah, excuse me, y'all, hallelujah. Uh-oh, y'all, excuse me, you can see I'm in the truck. Glory to God, something spilled over here. Hallelujah. Whenever you are fasting, glory to God, hallelujah, whenever you are fasting, do not look gloomy like the hypocrites. Do not, hallelujah, advertise that you're fasting. Hallelujah, in the way you look, the way you talk, the way you respond, like the hypocrites do. For they put on sad and dismal faces, like actors discoloring their faces with dirt and ashes. Uh-oh. They discolor their face with dirt and ashes. Hallelujah. What did they do that around that Mardi Gras thing, I think? They put those ashes on their, what's it called, Ash Wednesday. Come on. God is saying, don't do that. Excuse me. I'm just trying to get this thing together here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So that their fasting may be seen. Don't do like they do. For they put on sad and dismal faces so that their fasting may be seen by men. I assure you, Father God is saying, Jesus Christ, I assure you and most solemnly say to you, they already have their full reward. But when you fast, when we fast, saints of God, hallelujah, that's fasting in the right standing with God, fasting the, hallelujah, the Isaiah 58 fast, the fast that God has given us to fast. But when you fast, put oil, yeah, on your head, put oil, glory to God, yes, oh, anoint your head with oil, come on, y'all, hallelujah, anoint your head with oil, glory to God, thank you, God, hallelujah, hallelujah, barosha. Lord God, I thank you, I anoint my head with oil, glory to God, yes, Lord, when we fast, saints of the living God, hallelujah, we anoint our head with oil, guess what else we do? As you know, anoint your head with oil as you normally groom, as you would normally groom your hair. Wash your face. Cleanse your body. Don't go around musty. Don't go around stinking. Because if you're doing the right fast, that stuff, them impurities coming out. Hiya, Baba. So, oh, hallelujah. If we're doing the right fast, glory to God, them impurities coming out. So God is saying, groom. Groom, cleanse yourself, wash yourself. Hallelujah, wash the up and unders. Come on, that's basically what he's saying. And being nice about it. Wash the places. Hallelujah, where are them impurities coming out? They're coming out your pores, they're coming out every opening. Glory to God. They come out every gate. Glory to God. They come out in your breath. They come out under your arms. They come out even in your ears, your nose, your eyes. Glory to God. Them impurities, and things that's been in your body, that's been, hallelujah, trying to kill you, trying to attack you. Hallelujah. That's been pulling you away from God. That stuff is coming out. Glory to God. If you've been an alcoholic, that stuff is coming out. If you've been a drug addict, that stuff is coming out. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Wash your face so that your fasting will not be noticed by people, but by your Father who is in secret. And your Father who sees what is done in secret will reward you openly. Verse 19, it says, do not stir up yourselves. I'm sorry, do not store up for yourselves material treasures on earth, where moth and rust can destroy them, and where thieves can break in and steal them. But store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust can destroy, and where thieves do not break in and steal. Come on, let's be rich towards God. For where your treasures are, where my treasures located, that's where my heart is going to be. Hallelujah. Where I put, hallelujah, put my prized possessions, where I think my prized possessions are, that's where my heart's going to be at. That's what God is saying. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I thank you. The eye, verse 22, the eye is the lamp of the body. Glory to God. Oh, the eyes, our eyes are the lamp of our body. Glory to God. I'm worked up, y'all. I'm worked up. Glory to God. Trying to clean up this spill too. Hallelujah. So if the eyes, hallelujah, if our eyes are clear, spiritually perceptive, hallelujah, your whole body will be full of light, benefiting from God's precepts. But if your eye, if my eye is blind, spiritually bad, spiritually blinded, my whole body will be full of darkness, devoid of God's precepts. So if the very light inside of me, my inner self, my heart, my conscience is darkness, how great and terrible is that darkness? Come on. That's an ugly thing there. Hallelujah. To have that inner conscience, your heart dark. Hallelujah. Your inner self dark. My God. Hallelujah. Woo. That's a thought process. Your thought process, having a dark thought process, thinking of dark things that are not holy. No one can serve two masters in 24, for either he will hate one and love the other. Glory to God. Either he will hate one and love the other, or he will be devoted to one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and mammon. Money, possessions, fame, status, or whatever is valued more than the Lord. That's what mammon is. Mammon is money, possessions, fame, status, or whatever is valued more than Jesus Christ. Therefore, in 25 it says, therefore, I tell you, stop being worried or anxious, perpetually uneasy, distracted about your life. Woo, God is good. As to what you will eat, as to what you will drink, nor about your body, as to what you will wear. Is life more than food? Is life more than body and more than your clothing? that you place on your body. Look at the birds of the air. They neither sow nor do they reap. They neither sow seed nor do they reap the harvest, nor gather the crops into barns. Now, they don't gather their crops into barns. Yet their heavenly Father, your heavenly Father, keeps feeding them. Are you not, hallelujah, worth, hallelujah, much more than them? And who of you, by worrying, can add 1 hour to the length of his life? And why are you worried about your clothes? See how the lilies and the wildflowers of the field grow. They do not labor, nor do they spin. Nor do they spin wool to make clothes. Yet I say to you that not even Solomon in all of his glory and splendor dressed himself like one of these. But if God so clothes the grass, if God can clothe the grass of the field, which is alive and green today, and tomorrow is cut and thrown as fuel into the furnace, will he not much more clothe me and you? You of little faith, therefore be not worried. Do not worry. Do not worry or be anxious, perpetually uneasy or distracted, saying, what are we going to eat? Or what are we going to drink? Or what are we going to wear? For the, hallelujah, for the pagans, the pagan Gentiles eagerly seek all of these things. But do not worry, for your heavenly Father knows what you need. He knows you need them. But first and most importantly, seek, aim at, strive after his kingdom and his righteousness, his way of doing and being right. The attitude and character of God. Seek after that. Search for that. Be anxious for those things. Be anxious to know the kingdom of God. Be anxious to strive for righteousness. Be anxious to know the attitude and character of God. And all these things will be added unto you also. All the things that you want, all the things that you need, your clothing, your food, your drink, what you're going to wear, what you're going to buy, how you're going to, hallelujah, take care of yourself. All of those things are going to be added to you. Verse 34 of Matthew 6. So do not worry about tomorrow. Hallelujah. Let us not worry about tomorrow. For tomorrow will worry about itself. Each day has enough trouble. Glory to God. Of its own. Glory to God. Each day has enough trouble of its own, so don't worry about tomorrow. Glory to God. I thank God that he speaks over our lives. He prophesies every time we wake up. He's already prophesying his greatness. He's already prophesied his provision for us. Glory to God. He's already prophesied his wealth. Glory to God into our lives. So there's no need to worry. He knows exactly what we need. Hallelujah. He knows exactly what we need. Glory to God. God knows exactly what we need. Hallelujah. Guys, I'm going to come back with 7. I pray that you have a great evening. Glory to God. Thank you for bearing with me as I was messing around in this truck. Hopefully, when I come back, things will be settled. Glory to God. I hope you could hear me. I hope the music wasn't too loud. Glory to God. In Jesus' name. You have a great day, y'all. Bye.